seeing the Lord? Could it really have been Jesus? Might it just have been some group hallucination? Could it really be that this is happening? It feels like a weird dream. Could it really be? The world is kept on spinning, and yet here they are in grief and anxiety and fear. We know these questions. Could it really be? We have some of these same questions. Could it really be that something could come from nothing, that life could come from death? Could it really be that God is faithful to God's promises? Could it really be that God actually does love me just as I am, not because of anything I have done, but because God's love is that great? Could God really love me? Could God really love all? Could it really be? We can find ourselves closed in to rooms, worried and wondering, locked inside with fear and worry and disbelief, locked inside as we are disheartened and unsure of God's presence, of God's faithfulness to God's promises. Could it really be? We close ourselves in, we wonder, hey, and I close in everything around me and wonder and worry and sit and wait and wait. Do you know the great thing about being closed in to a room? You know the interesting thing about being inside of a home with locked doors? The resurrected Jesus is really, really good at showing up in rooms that are closed in, where the doors have been locked. He does it twice in our text today. You see, even when we are closed in, even when we have closed ourselves in, or have been set away, Jesus comes into the rooms where we are. The resurrected Jesus finds his way in to these rooms where we have locked ourselves or been locked away. And when he shows up, peace be with you. And when he shows up, he sends us out. As the Father has sent me, so I send you. You are to continue this same work and mission and ministry that I have been about. And when Jesus, the resurrected Jesus, shows up and he says peace and he sends us out, he does not send us alone, but breathes the very breath of God, the very presence of God's own Holy Spirit into those disciples in that room and into us this day. When Jesus, the resurrected Christ, shows up, peace. Receive the Holy Spirit. Go and continue this work and ministry that God has been up to in Jesus the whole time. God is, in fact, faithful to God's promises. We heard Peter in Acts and in 1 Peter outline the ways in which God has been faithful to God's people all along. And even so, we have heard how God is faithful in Jesus the Christ throughout the Gospel of John, so that we who don't see in the same way that those first disciples did can yet come to trust that God is faithful to God's promises, that love is stronger than death, that life can come from death, something from nothing. God shows up, gives us peace, offers God's very self, is as close to us as the very breath we breathe in, and sends us out of the rooms in which we have enclosed ourselves. So we might, in this Easter season, dare to open up our hearts and our minds to the fact that it really could be that Jesus is alive, that it really could be that the peace of Christ is ours. We might of Jesus, but even when we find ourselves closed off, even when our worries and our doubts close us off, Jesus comes anyway. He shows up. He offers us peace. He shows up for the apostles when they're together, and he shows up for Thomas when he asks. The risen Christ comes among us and says, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." This work continues. Easter is not an end, but a beginning